What is Cromerix the Invincible in Borderlands? Considered to be the very first ever raid boss in the Borderlands video games, Cromerix was seen as a giant crab worm, and he was hibernating in a secret area of Pandora. His lair was disturbed when the Crimson Lance excavated the area in search of more Iridian. Unknown to them, they proceeded forward, only to get killed by Cromerix. Later on, some signs were placed near the entrance to warn off future travelers. Now it's possible Cromerix might be the last of his kind and was hibernating and hiding to survive. This species seems to favor moist environments and tends to die off in the dry desert. It's not explained how Cromerix ended up in this area. Perhaps he always lived there. Maybe there was once a time when water once flourished across this land. If any unfortunate souls would dare enter this area, an elevator leading to his lair can be found. It was left behind and abandoned. Once you reach the top, a laser grid will block your exit, forcing you into a battle to the death against the mighty Cromerix. He appears from the ground and is assisted by three other types of worms: the craw maggots that are weak to electricity, the green craw worms that are weak to fire, and the armored craw worms that are weak to corrosive acid. They will surround the player in an attempt of overwhelming them. More of them will appear as they try to defend their master. Cromerix is known to attack with its giant claws, diving into the ground and bursting out to deliver a shockwave, and he can spit out giant balls of acid. His body is fully armored, with only a few critical points being susceptible to damage. With each body part being destroyed, Cromerix lets out a loud roar and continues to fight on, as more of his servants come to his aid. When he is finally defeated, the spoils of battle are yours. Cromerix is known to drop the rarest loot on Pandora. In some occasions, he is seen to drop pearlescent items. After his death, the legend of Cromerix lived on. Stories about him were mentioned by some people in Sanctuary during the story of Borderlands 2. Later on, an expansion pack was created, and the end boss was the son of Cromerix the Invincible. He looked very similar in design, but with different colors on his body. And just like his father, he had minions to aid him in battle. But this time, Craboids and Varkids would spawn to attack the player. While he also shares the weaknesses of having some critical points on his body, he also developed a resistance to acid, explosives, and slag. Specific parts of his body tend to take more damage from fire. His hard shell can also deflect bullets. Now, the inspiration of Cromerix was based off a crayfish, but in the end, he was just a big larva crab worm. So, if you enjoyed this video, then leave a like and subscribe to my channel. And if you played the Borderlands video games, tell me which raid boss is your favorite. Thanks for watching. My name is Acid Glow, and I'll see you in the next video.